Yo te puse High Commissioner, senior members of the staff on my left, our elders who are here this morning, it's my honor and pleasure to welcome you here. All of you manifestly appear to be in good health, and we thank God for you. Now we have listened carefully to all that you have said. The most noteworthy aspect of your speech is the open confession that all of you have related in perfect friendship and that all is well within you. We thank God for that. It's our prayer that God continue to sustain you with good health, happiness. Now, I want to say that notwithstanding the fact that you live here, it is still easy for you to lend support to your country in various ways. I want to cancel that. I'm sure that from time to time some of you go home. But those of you who, because of age, are not able to go, there are so many other ways you can relate with the home, with your homes. And if that being proves difficult, you can pray for those at home. Nigeria is making progress. I'm sure you will have heard of that. And our wish is that all of you here continue to pray for our country so that it can prosper, so that there can be stability, and so that those of your children who have been elected to regularly go home will find pleasure in being so. Everywhere you go, in any part of the world, it's always important to have elders guiding and directing things. We counsel you to play the role of elders in your various communities. You mentioned the assistance on the PV when you wanted to secure. We are glad. We want to assure you that as often as you require assistance, come knocking. We shall respond faithfully because we are part of you as Nigerians. But I'm touched by the remark you make about Kanuk. I think the problems within that organization are still persisting, because I had cause to intervene on one occasion. I want to counsel that you find a time, rally around, and bring your other colleagues to settle this rift. It's not of any benefit, either to you or to us, for Nigerians to leave their home far behind and come and start quarreling in Britain. Whatever problems there are, I entreat you to intervene and settle. God bless you. God grant you a long lease of life. You look robust. May you continue to look even better. Thank you very much.
It appears that today I am speechless. And that maybe I don't have much to say other than to welcome you, like the High Commissioner has done. And to thank you also for what you have been doing for the community. And also to urge you to play the role of elders. Elders, I presume, are supposed to settle quarrels or disagreements among younger ones. And we have a lot of them that are young here. They have not seen what you have seen. And they may not be able to foresee things that your experience will avail you to see in the future. So I think this should be a role that you should play. The High Commissioner has mentioned some rift within the this group of people in other parts of the world. There's always been that problem within and also inter and intra. You have Nido, you have Kano. You see a lot of conflict between the two of them. So you have your role cut out for you to get elders. That is to bring them together. Yes, we have the official capacity to do that, but there is also an informal way of doing it. And I think you hold the key to that. I congratulate you for all that you have done. You have spent many years now. By 2019, you will be 30 years. So the good that you have done in the last 30 years, we expect you to do even more in the next 30 years.